scripture is God-breathed and useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness. Training in righteousness.
Good morning, K-35 friends. Today, we're going to continue to read from Nehemiah chapter 8, verses 1 through 3. So if you have your Bibles, I want you guys to open your Bible to Nehemiah chapter 8, verses 1 through 8. All the people came together as one in the square before the water gate. They told Ezra, the teacher of the law, to bring out the book of the law of Moses, which the Lord had commanded for Israel. So on the first day of the seventh month, Ezra the priest brought the law before the assembly, which was made up of men and women and all who were able to understand. He read it aloud from daybreak till noon as he faced the square before the water gates. In the presence of the men, women, and the others who could understand. And all the people listened attentively to the book of the law. Amen. The walls around Jerusalem were finished. With God's help, the people finished the rebuilding the walls and the city gates in 52 days. Ezra the priest and scribe had traveled from Babylon to Jerusalem with a group of God's people, and God was with Ezra, and Ezra wanted to study God's law, obey it, and teach it to God's people. And Ezra met with some of the people of Israel, and he learned that some of the people had their leaders had disobeyed God, ignoring his word. And Ezra tore his clothes and pulled out his hair and some of his hair, and he sat down and was very upset, and he was crying over and over and over. And Ezra knelt and prayed to God, confessing the people's sin. And as he did, God's people began to gather around him, and they cried and they offered sacrifices and promising to be faithful to God. And several years later, the people in Jerusalem gathered together early in the morning at one of Jerusalem's gates. Men, women, and children, anyone who could understand came to listen to the reading of God's word. As the sun was just coming up, Ezra brought out the book of the law of Moses that God had given to the people, and God's words were written on a scroll. So I brought a little scroll right here. What he did was Ezra had the scripture scroll, and he opened the scroll and he read the law of Moses to the people in front of him. And Ezra stood on a high wooden platform and began to read. And Ezra read the law for hours, and all the people listened carefully. The people stood up, and they had respect for God's word. And Ezra praised God, and the people lifted up their hands. Amen, amen. And they said, the people in the crowd bowed down with their faces to the ground, and they worshiped God. And some of the leaders there, the Levites, explained the law to the people and helped them, because a lot of the people, especially the children, they had no idea what the law of God was saying. So there were the priests and the Levites who were in between the people among the crowds to help them understand. And as the people heard the words of the law, they began to cry because their hearts were so convicted by the law of God that these laws actually helped them to understand how much God loved them. And the law was God's rules for living. And the people had disobeyed God, and they realized that they had sinned against God. So Ezra, the Levites, and the Nehemiah, the governor, said, "This day is holy to the Lord your God. Do not be sad or cry. Even though the people's sin has made them really sad, this was a happy, happy day." Then Ezra said to them, "Go home and prepare a feast. Eat rich food and drink sweet drinks. Share what you have prepared with those who have nothing prepared." So he told the people, gather all the food, eat them, have a feast, and share your food with people who have nothing prepared. And the people obeyed Ezra. They prepared a feast, and they were glad because they understood the words of the law that were explained to them. God's word is very powerful. Just like Ezra, you know, we don't have this kind of scroll with us, but we have the scripture, we have the Bible, and they're a powerful thing. God's word is really powerful. When Ezra read God's word, the people loved God more, and their hearts were changed. The Bible says that Jesus is the word. Jesus is God who came to live with people on earth, and Jesus has the power to change our hearts. So boys and girls, as we think about today's passage, I want you guys to think about this one thing. Even though we don't have the law of Moses anymore, but we have this new law inside of our hearts. The new law is to love God and love our neighbor. And we have to continuously remember that we are the new people, new covenant in Jesus Christ. So as we think about today's passage, I want you guys to remember this truth, that the God's word is powerful and it can change our lives. Let us all close our eyes and fold our hands, and I will pray for all of us. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for today's message. As we are finishing up Nehemiah, we have learned that they have built the walls to protect themselves and their family and their friends. But not only that, Father, when everything was finished, when the temple was finished, when the walls were rebuilt and everything, Ezra came to read the word of God. And that word reminded the people the first love that they had for God. So Father, we pray that even though we don't have the scroll of scripture with us, but we have the Bible that contains the Old Testament and the New Testament. So Father, as we read our Bible, help us to remind who Jesus is. Thank you, Father. Change our hearts, and we pray everything in Jesus Christ's name. Amen.
Let's pray the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we also have forgiven our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For yours is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
like a tree firmly planted I'll be, grounded in your word. I will delight in the law of the Lord, I will meditate day and night. Then like a tree firmly planted I'll be, grounded in
who follows the way of the Lord. Blessed is the one.
I will delight in the law of the Lord, I will meditate day and night. Then like a tree firmly planted I'll be, grounded in your word.
Blessed is the one who follows the way of the Lord. Blessed.